Hi there. So I'm working with the fx-9750G3 graphing calculator, and I'm going to show you how to put the calculator into exam mode. And I'm doing this with two different things. On the left, you'll see the emulator, the online software that you can have. And then on the right, you'll see, using my document camera, you'll see the hardware, the actual calculator. I'm going to put the actual calculator into exam mode, and I'm going to use the emulator to walk through the steps so that you can see how it works. So the first thing in the menu of both, you'll see that they have the same menu screen going right now. I want to get to the link menu. So we're going to arrow down and over till I get to this link. I could push E, or I can just hit execute once I get that. So let's do the same thing with our handheld calculator here. And we're going to hit execute. And so notice the first thing it does, the default page is to the type of communication. How are you connecting to a computer? This is USB. The calculator right now says 3-pin. That's not what we care about. If you look across the bottom here, what we want to do is exam. So F3, and I'm going to hit F3 here, same menu. So let's just walk through what these are. So unlock, this is how do you unlock your examination mode. F2 is help. We're going to go into that. It says step by step. F3, let's just show you what that is. This is telling you what happens when exam mode is in effect. And so it restricts certain applications. So it restricts the e-activities, the econ, the finance activities, the memory. So students can't recall anything that was in memory in case they put a program or something in there. They can't open the programs. They can't open Python, which is a programming app. And any other add-ins. So the add-ins in this particular calculator would be a geometry application add-in that I might have added, or the probability. So all of those things that get locked down and students are unable to access them. So let's hit exit. What we are going to do right now, we're eventually going to do F2 and F4. So first we're going to go through the help steps, and I'm going to do the steps on the actual calculator. So let's go F2 here on the emulator, and notice that the first step is to turn the calculator off. And so that's what we're going to do here on the actual hard calculator here. So it's going to be shift and the all clear button. And that, as you can see, is turning off my calculator. So my calculator is off. And so let's scroll down on the emulator here to the next step. And notice that the next step is you need to hit three buttons at the same time. So I need to try to make sure I hit these three buttons at the same time. So here's my 7, here's the cosine button, and here's the all clear. So let's hit all of them at once. And the first thing that comes up, let me see if you can see that a little better, is a question. Do you want to enter exam mode? So let's scroll down here on the emulator and see what step 3 says. So step 3 says press F1. Yes, we want to hit exam mode. So I'm going to press F1. And the next one, the step says to hit F2. So what is F2? And if you notice, it's telling me, are you sure you want to do exam mode? Is explained in the link app, which we've already looked at. Do you want to continue? That's F2. Or do you want to stop? So you have the option at this point to change your mind. But we're going to hit F2. And so now it says you are in exam mode. So let's hit exit. And I'm in exam mode. So what does that mean? And so you'll notice that was the last step. So you'll notice that the menus come up. But there's this, hopefully you can see, this blinking R, meaning you're in restricted mode. This is how you know a calculator is in exam mode, because you are restricted. So if we go down, and what we say, one of the things that can't be opened is the E activities. So if you had like an activity with solving equations, if we hit execute, it says, sorry, you can't get in that, you're in exam mode. And if we went down to programs, nope, sorry, you're in exam mode. So there are certain things students are unable to do because they're in exam mode. Probability is an add-in app. Let's click it, and it says, nope, can't do that. So exam mode restricts some of the things that might help students, you know, doing programs and stuff, solve exam questions without having to show work, kind of thing. So now we're in exam mode. So let's put this calculator down, and let's hit exit on our emulator software, because now we're in exam mode with the calculator. But how do I get out of exam mode? So I'm going to go in the emulator to talk about that. So F4, there's a couple ways that you could do this. You could connect your calculator, so the hardware. You'll notice that there's a little 3-pin button here. You can connect that to another calculator that's not in exam mode and go through the steps to unconnect. Or if you want to use this calculator, we could use our link app again and press F2. Or, and I'm going to put this down, we could connect it to a calculator and follow these steps. But my favorite thing, so there's a lot of things about connecting to the calculator in the link app, USB cable, those types of things. But my favorite thing in the Casio is this last option. This last option is probably, as a teacher, the one that I would use the most. Because most of the time when you are putting something in exam mode, you're doing it because there's a standardized test coming up or something that we don't want students to have access to certain things. And so you do it usually the day before or that morning, and now all the calculator students are using are in exam mode. They work on the exam and they're done and they go home. It expires in an hour or 12 hours, I'm sorry, 12 hours. It's just gonna miraculously turn off in 12 hours. And when I turn the calculator back on, it'll be back in its normal mode. This is the mode I would most likely use all the time because I don't have to do anything. I just have to wait it out. And usually you're waiting it out anyway because you are, you know, working with students taking a test during the exam. So you can do it. If we scroll back, there's lots of ways to connect to the computer, terminate the connection, connect to a calculator that doesn't have it on and disconnect that way. Lots of different options. But for me, the easiest one is to simply wait it out. But you have these nice step-by-steps that tell you exactly what you need to do.